We have a morning briefing, which kind of kicks off and says, this is what's going to happen. We need a team to go do this. We need a team to go do that. This is who our team leads are. This is the process. And then we let those folks loose to go do the good work. And we're going to try to share some of that information with you. So as we discuss that, we have some maps and some additional information up here with us right now. I will talk about a couple of these locations here to the best of my ability. Obviously, there's a lot of us here, and this isn't ideal as far as these maps go. But if you look at this boat launch overview as an example, this dot here is that Lisbon boat launch area that we've discussed. That's where the suspect's vehicle was located ultimately, that white Subaru station wagon. And I will also say that we'll have these three primary maps, but this QR code here, and whether you can get it from your seats or come up after the fact, will give the digital version of those so you have those readily available. You certainly understand how all of that works. So we talk about that boat launch area, and that particular location is 501 Lisbon Street, Pejebscot Landing. Pejebscot Landing is at this location. I believe we have some of our friends from the media that are out in that area now. And what will happen in this general location today is that we will be putting divers in the water along that Androscoggin River, which you see here. And that's gonna look like a couple of different things. So the very first thing that you're gonna see out there is you're gonna see some air resources that will fly over this particular area. And they're looking to see what can we clear from the air. Do I have to put divers in that particular area, or can I tell from the top, based on the current and how muddy the water is and all those other things, can I see to the very bottom here? So that's gonna start this entire process. Then there's gonna be some screening and some divers that are actually in the water that may start on this side by the boat launch and will continue on this side. I would envision at some point that we'll be moving over to these particular locations here for ground searches as well. So that's gonna look like a bunch of different things. So they could be dragging a diver behind them, literally, while that diver is checking for evidence, checking for potential bodies. And I would also say that while this is gonna look like a major focus today with a lot of people, we have a lot of other irons in the fire. So I'm not here saying that the suspect, we know the suspect is in the water and this is what we're doing. What I'm telling you is you're gonna see a lot of activity here, and I'm gonna tell you that in advance. We've got nothing to hide in that regard at all. So then you're gonna have some sonar as well that's gonna be utilized here, and that can look like a couple of different things. A remote operating vehicle, an ROV, is divers could use that, and that will look like a pod under the water, and that is looking for sonar, so picking up shadows, if you will, of what does that look like? Could be a log, could be anything under there. And our divers, that dive team, and that when I say, again, our divers, that's going to be teams from all over the place. Our Maine Warden Service is heavily involved in this. We work with them all the time. The Maine State Police dive team will be in the water and will be leading this initiative. So that's what we'll see here with a couple of different kinds of sonar. And then along the shoreline, you're going to see a line search, if you will. That means literally officers online as they're working that shoreline. And of course, they're looking for evidence. They're looking for everything, anything that may help them down the road. Now, I say you'll see this because for us, we want to make sure that we're working with you. So there is a church parking lot across the road here. And there's also some parking available on this side of the road. Mark Laddie, who is the PIO from the Maine Warden Service, and some officers will be in this area to assist. So if you decide that you want to go to that location to pick up video and see what they're up to, then I think there's some parking opportunities here. This 196 can be busy. This area here happens to be pretty low speed. At least that's what the speed limit is. So we're going to be around there to try to keep that as safe as possible. But we want you to be mindful that we may ask you not to stand on a railroad trestle, or, you know, we want you to get your coverage. We want to be partners with you. However, you're not going to be able to have full access to that site. I think that's common sense, and we want to make sure that you can do your jobs and we can help you facilitate that. So you're going to see a bunch of people in that area, that 531 Lisbon Road. A couple of these other locations, if we start here, This is the bowling alley scene. This red dot is actually where that is. You all understand that. We will have some additional officers there checking this wood line and continuing to do those sweeps, those searches. There was a lot of shots fired in these locations. We want to make sure we have all the evidence humanly possible. And then this is far from ideal, considering it's directly behind the podium. But this is... Can we do that? We're jammed in here with the wall. Yeah, we may lean towards that QR code. If you can't see that, I apologize. We'll have to take a look at this particular option in the future if this works for us. But the bar and grill here, there is a red dot, and you can see some wood line around that. Each one of these locations is going to have lots of police officers there, as you imagine. A piece of all of these things will have a QRF, or a quick reaction force. So we're going to maintain security here because clearly, as you realize, the suspect in this case is not in custody. That continues to be our focus. And I think if you look at these two things, we have an investigative bucket with a great deal of resources that are investigating the crime, what occurred. And there's clearly an apprehension team here with a lot of folks that are involved in that. And of course, they're going to intermingle. That's a given. But I think in this scenario, I want you to keep those two things in mind, because even though we're going to be active with this search and the investigative side, always in our mind, we're going to be looking for the suspect and making sure that the people that are involved in these various searches, to include yourselves, are safe. So that is clearly another focus that we have in mind. I would also like to talk about if we talk about procedures, you talk about practices. There was a lot of activity last night from members of the media in Bowdoin. And what I would tell you is that I'm showing you these three locations. There's a bunch of others that we're going to be working on. And that's not, so we don't have 50 maps up here. We're just going to be working on other locations. And that's not meant to be secretive. That's just to tell you that we're going to be all over the place. That's not saying that we know that the individual is in this house, or we know the individual is in that house, or they're in that swath of land, this acreage. That's not what we're doing. But we do look at all these situations as if the individual could be in there. And if that's the case, you'll see tactical teams at some point. A lot of folks are just dressed in a more casual manner, or a BDU, a battle dress uniform, just because they're going to be out in the woods and they're going to be out crawling around. So that doesn't mean, just because we're making announcements on over a PA system, that the individual is in there and we have an armed standoff and there are police swarming. There's just a lot of resources that it takes to work these scenes, right? I mean, I think that part of it, again, is common sense. And we want to be as forthright as we can around that as well. We won't be able to say every time we're hitting a location, hey, we're going to be at this spot, and because that's just not practical. And it's not safe for a lot of folks. So if you hear announcements in PA systems, as an example, a piece of that is us just giving notification that, yes, in fact, we are the police. We are going to be knocking on this door. We would like you to come out if you're in there. Some of that is case law oriented. Some of that is best practice. And some of that's just standard operating procedures from our end. So keep that in mind. If you have a question, you can certainly reach out to Shannon Moss. Many of you have. And if we can answer it, we will. It may not be immediate, but we're going to do the best we can to do that. And I think we'll be better at that, again, as we kind of get into this flow. Now we know what we're working with. It's starting to settle in as much as a tragedy like this can. And again, we want to be good partners with you across the board.